Vanda Khmer Blood. I think it's called Khmer Blood. Was it Khmer Blood? Am I saying it right? Khmer Blood, or is it like Khmer Blood? I've been seeing a lot of like suggestions in my comments. Like a lot of people have been telling me to react to this song, Khmer Blood or Khmer Blood. Like a lot of you guys have been like in my comments, like on the Born This Way one, and I think on the last one I dropped, the Time to Rise. On Time to Rise, yeah, you guys have also like told me like react to this one. I really like this one. Like so far, all of Vanda's stuff, I've been loving. I've been loving every one of them. And the one with F Hero and them, that was just as fire. Like you could tell the dude was in the class of his own as soon as he like stepped on the scene in that. But yeah, we're here with Vanda, Khmer Blood. I don't know how to say it. Y'all let me know in the comments. But yeah. That being said, let's get into this. Fair warning though, like every time I do music video reactions, sometimes my capture doesn't want to like really capture it well. You guys might see little jittery bits like every now and then, but then after a while, it's like it has to warm up to the video or something, and then after a while it starts playing alright. So you guys might see like little jittery bits. I've noticed it in my previous reactions, but yeah, you guys might see it like just moving like in frame rates for a couple of seconds, and then it starts playing. All right, so yeah, if you guys wondered what that was, it's not on your end, it's on my end. So yeah, that being said, let's get into this. Off the back, let me just say I really like the sound of this already with the drums. It sounds like just some Nashville drums that they're using there. I love the sound already. Like, I can already tell this is gonna be an amazing song. And it's like almost 5 minutes long, so it might be a lot of details again in this song. Say the earth is a pair of eyes, windows to the soul. It is like everything on earth, like that you're doing is like you're growing up on earth, and like everything, like the evolution of your life and everything, it's like a window to your soul. Like the earth is kind of what makes you, if that makes sense. I think that's kind of what Vanda's saying there. Like, it is a window to your soul. Everything you do, everything you like absorb, it's the window to your soul. It's a pair of eyes, a window to your soul. I agree with that. This is like I knew this was gonna be an interesting song again. They certainly do look to my boy as a superstar. And he says he talks to himself in the high skies. Like I said, yeah, Vanda is on a whole nother level. Like, yeah, like this dude is different. This dude is definitely different. Got some kids making noises outside. Like, I can't do anything about that. But yeah, this song is different. Like, all these songs are different. Born This Way was different. Time to Rise. Oh, that is still my favorite one. Unless Khmer Blood or Khmer Blood can like prove me wrong, it's still Time to Rise. Time to Rise is my favorite of the Vanda songs.
Okay.
Like, he's really trying to do it all. He says he's trying to live his life like a rock star, using only his hands, his eyes, and his body, basically, like, with, like, his the way he's living, like, the rap styles, well, the rapping that he's doing at the moment, the people that he's supporting, the people that he's helping with his hands, and the stuff that he sees, and with his body, he's, like, with, like, in his rap songs, like, demonstrating, like, everything that's going on in the world, well, where he's from, kind of, like, and, like, with his body, how can I explain it? It's just, like, physically helping what he means. Like, any way that he can go, that he can help with, or, like, convey a message to people through his songs and such. Like, that's what he means by using only my hands, my eyes, and body. Like, he's trying to live, like that rock star life, he said. If we go back, I want to live my life like a rock star. I like how this song is built. Like y'all said, like, Vander produces his own stuff. Like, it's just like a nice little, sounds like a nice little piano in the back with the drums just dup, 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 with the piano or the keyboard or something that's just like, it's just like, sounds like it was just two instruments used currently. I don't know if there's gonna be a beat switch, but yeah. This goes nicely with, like, his voice as well. My boy Vander out here trying to sing right now. This dude can do it all. Shout outs to Vander. See, he just shouted out my favorite rapper. Like, my favorite rapper of the American rappers is J. Cole. Like, for me, like, J. Cole is on a different level. People do say that Kendrick is better than Cole. I don't know. Like, I'm on a full-on Cole train than I am with Kendrick. Like, Kendrick is good. Don't get me wrong. Kendrick is good. But J. Cole is better for me, in my opinion. Like, J. Cole's always been my favorite. Me and him were born in the same year. And, I got so much respect for J. Cole. Just like I've got so much respect for Vander. And then my boy gonna say he's chilling over here like J. Cole. Yep, Vander already my favorite. This beat already switched it up nicely. That was a nice transition into where we are now. It's not a beat switch, but, like, yeah, that was just the intro, and now we're at the core of the song right now. But my boy over here said he's chilling like J. Cole. My blood is cold like the North Pole. Oof, that is a cold-blooded line, Vander. Pole, play me so old, bad girl. I ain't how hard did you tongue yo? I need a rum tack, oh shit. Better one die killing this bitch. Doing just assassin creep. Rebate them on up in this bitch. Break that you with them in draw cheap. Come to Kanye Charles to I'm trying to keep up with Vander right now. What's he saying? He said something about Assassin's Creed. I can make you fly like you're riding a swing. Yo, I need a rum tack, oh shit. Better one die killing this bitch. Doing just. Yeah, you always killing the beat, Vander. You always going in. Like, he different, like I said. Like, every time he spits something, he's always going in. Like, yeah, he's on a whole different level. He's killing the beat already. Like, he's killing it right now. And then he says he's like a ninja Assassin's Creed. Like, he's quietly doing his thing. Like, without anybody noticing. That's what he means by the ninja Assassin's Creed bar. Like, because we know the assassins in Assassin's Creed does everything in silence. And they take people down, take people out, and they dip. You didn't even know they were there. Same thing with ninjas. Ninjas do the same thing. Like, they one with the shadows, like, when they land on their feet, you don't even hear them land. They just strike from out of nowhere. From what I've seen in like ninja movies and such, it's the shinobi, right? Yeah, like that's what I got from that bar when he says he's like a ninja Assassin's Creed. This dude moves in silence. Whenever he does things, you don't even know what he's done, but he's done them. That's a nice little bar. I like that. Ooh, don't abandon your work, keep working on it, see? Right there, don't abandon your work, keep working on it. He said this in several videos that he's done already. Said this in Born This Way, and he said this in the one with Master Kong, Time to Rise. He said it in Run This Town as well. He said he's gonna keep telling y'all and telling probably his friends as well. Don't abandon your work. Keep working on it. Like, just watch your work grow with anything that you do. Like, keep working on it. He's not just talking about music. He's talking about whether you're acting, your movies, or like if you're like a lawyer, or if you're like, it means in general. Like if. This is what you dreamt of becoming. Keep working on it. Watch it grow. Like, what more can you do? Don't abandon it. Just keep going. Keep pushing forward. Ooh, suffer for it like a slave. Hold up, what do you say? The path of life is not the same thing as the path we walk. Suffer for it like a slave. Damn. Like, yeah, you gotta, like, in other words, keep grinding. Keep working hard. Keep trying to get to where you want to get to. And sometimes you gotta suffer for it like a slave. Like, if you look at, like, the slavery times, like, It was hard on the slaves out there, but eventually they got out of that period to like become a better version of themselves. Yes, they probably have PTSD from what happened, but they're that's in their past now, and they've kind of grown from it. It's kind of what he's saying. You gotta suffer for your. Sometimes you gotta suffer for your work. Like, if you wanna get to a goal, get to where you wanna get to, you gotta like sometimes push yourself through the most difficult times. You gotta suffer for it, if that makes sense. I'm not saying that slavery was fair though. Slavery was definitely not fair. That was some of the coldest things that people could do to other human beings. To this day, it's still happening. Like, even in workplaces, like some people, like the office workers are living a better life than the warehouse workers. It's, man. But yeah, I'm not saying slavery is right. I'm just saying what Vanda's saying is sometimes you gotta slave through your work to get to where you wanna be. Like, it's not gonna be an easy road. It's always gonna be obstacles in the way that's gonna make it tough for you, that to the point where you're like, you know what? I give up. But never say those words. Never say I give up. Keep pushing forward. Get past that. Get past that obstacle that you think is holding you back. Because if you can get past that, you can accomplish anything. And that's what Vanda was saying there. Ooh, some what do you say? Some people cough blood. Some get blood clots. Yeah. Some wanna be famous even if it drains their blood dry. Yeah. Damn. Yeah, some people, it do be like that. Some people work extra hard. They like be pushing themselves. I mean, look like Heath Ledger and like Joaquin Phoenix, Christian Bale and them. They're like method actors. Like, they be doing a lot. For their fame, they be like, it's hard to explain, but method actors hit different. Like, they even if it drains their blood dry. Like, you get this in the music industry, you get this in the movie industry as well. You get this in a lot of like departments as well. Like that, some people want to be famous even if it drains their blood dry. Sometimes that's a good thing. Sometimes it's not a bad. It's not a good thing, because like if you push yourself, you might die early. You might pass away early or something. Like, you don't want your blood to be drained. Your blood drained dry. I couldn't say that word there for a second. You wanna at least enjoy some of the stuff that you done. Don't push yourself too far. But yeah, some people do want to be famous even if it drains their blood dry. Like, don't overwork it. Don't push yourself too far over the limits. Try and find some sort of balance. I think that's kind of what Vanda is trying to say. Yeah, like, he says the paths that I've walked are sown with blood. Ooh, that's like when people gossip about you. That's what he's saying. Like, some people play the good guy and I'm the villain. Like, it'd be like that. People pretend to be like victims. They play victim. I see this a lot at my job where I work at as well. You're just trying to be your own person, and then somebody's gotta like get on your nerves or try to annoy you or something, and like the minute you retaliate, then they go tell everybody else, like, oh yeah, and then he said this about me, then he said this about me, and like I didn't mean it like that. See, they're playing victim. Now they're playing the good guy, and suddenly I'm the villain. That's exactly what Vanda's saying there. So yeah, I feel that bar. That is exactly how it is. Like, people try to say stuff about Vanda, try to be the good guy, and make him out to be the villain, when in reality it's the other way around. He's actually the good guy and they the villains for doing that. They said that they're the wolves and I'm the sheep. Ooh. Yeah. Like I said, it's the other way around. Same with me. Like, people think I'm a sheep, that I'd be following in the same, the same chain link as everyone else. Nah, I'm the loose link. I'm the link that's not connected to that chain. I'm with Vanda on that. Like, I try to do my own thing. Yes, I'm working at the moment. Like, I try to get my reactions in here and there, but I'm gonna try and go into full reaction sooner or later. Maybe move away from that job eventually, but we'll see how it goes. Like, but even with like not just my work, I try to do like music. I've done my reaction. I've tried doing some gaming videos. That came to a stop for a little bit. I jumped over to the reaction side of things, entertaining everybody, and like I've done skits on TikTok. I'm trying to do different things. I'm just doing different things. I'd be writing books. Like, I'm trying different things. Like Vanda over here. Like he's spoken about it like in his other music videos as well. But yeah, you gotta be the you can either be a lone wolf or you can be a wolf in sheep's clothing. That's kind of what I am, the wolf in sheep's clothing. But yeah, they're over here trying to say that Vanda is the wolf, is the sheep. He's trying to follow what everyone else is doing. I beg to differ. From what I've seen, this dude is the wolf. They cannot say nothing about my boy Vanda. Forced to adapt an environment opposite to most other countries. Yeah, that's how it'd be. That's exactly how it'd be. You adapted to like the environment of what's it, Cambodia or wherever he's from, opposite to some other countries where, like, I'm not saying it's like that in America or the UK and such, but like the lifestyle is different out here. It's more first classy and such, but like he was forced to like adapt to the, I think it's like almost like the slums now I wouldn't say the slums, but like it's out where I came from as well. Like it's kind of similar to that. Like if I've taken an example, my father, he grew up in some hardships, like out in South Africa. He grew up with some out of character people. Like He basically grew up in the hood life. Like he had to adapt to that environment, opposite to what other people grew up in. Like he didn't grow up in a nice life, but eventually he broke free from that. He grew into someone better. He had a son, and yeah, I'm the product of that. Well, not that environment, but of the person that he became. And yeah, I'm just kind of carrying on that legacy. So hopefully eventually my son will also be like a better version of what I am. If that makes sense. But yeah, he was forced to adapt. You just gotta adapt. You gotta make the best out of the hard life that you grew up in or is growing up in. Like you make the best out of it. You become someone big. You get some fame out of it, or it's hard to explain. Vanda is explaining it in the video though, but yeah, just make the best out of a bad situation. That's the word I was trying to get at. You see, he stayed sharp, stayed strong, dancing around like it was ballet and such. He adapted to the world that he grew up in. He was born this way. What do you say? You said back in the day when I was weaker. Even when I was right, they said I was wrong. Said that I'm just a kid and a newcomer. Like that's what I'm saying. Like people always try to say like, nah, you're wrong. They always try to be trying to say that they know what's best for you, or like, you try to, like, how can I explain this? I do get this a lot as well. Like I can relate to everything dude's saying right now. Like I come up with an idea, like, yeah, I've this has happened to me a lot around here, not just in my workplace, but like different social groups that I've mixed with. Like I try to come up with an idea, and they're like, yeah, but let's try it this way instead. And I'm like, yeah, but this might be an easier way to do this. And they're like, yeah, but no, you're still a newcomer to this. Like exactly like what Vanda's saying. They try to say that even when you're right, they still try to prove you wrong. Like that. When you try to give them an easier method, they still try to do the hard way to get past things. I don't know how to explain it, but they still try to do the hard way, even if you've given them an easier way, just to prove something like that they're above you. So like Fred, yeah, he's trying to come with fresh ideas, but yeah, that's what I'm getting from that. Learning to become acquainted with the backstabbers. Learning to become acquainted with the backstabbers. Like, yeah, he's playing them, basically. Like those who talk behind his back, he's learning to be like their friends and such, seeing what they're about. But like he doesn't trust them. It's kind of what, how can I say that? In general, this, like, again, this is life again. Like people talk behind your back, those who pretend to be your friend but aren't. You just gotta, it's hard to explain, but you just gotta let it be sometimes. So he, like he says, he's learning to become acquainted with the backstabbers, those who are pretending to be his friends. He's just gonna keep doing what he's doing, not really pay them much mind. They can talk behind his back, try to, like, basically stab him in his back, but he's not gonna acknowledge them. That's kind of what he's saying here. I think I've seen that bar before when, yeah, I don't get stomach pains anymore because I can finally afford good food. Yeah, he's like worked his way up from the struggles to where he is now. Like, now he can afford whatever he wants. Like, he's gone through that hardship. He's lived that life. He's, like, pushed himself. He's, like, acquainted himself with these backstabbers. He's adapted to the environment. And, like, he's broken free from that in a way. And, yeah, with the money he's making now, he can actually afford good food as to the stuff that he was affording back then. Like, it was a struggle. Everybody goes through these struggles as well. Like, not everybody, but most people do go through these struggles where it's like they had, like I said, my father was the same. Like, he was literally on the streets at one point, to a point that he's like eating that good food now. He can finally afford that good food. So yeah, much respect to Vanda. Vanda always keeps it real 100% of the time. So is that what he's like referring to, like when he says, because I got camera blood in me, in my veins, to protect me, like because of where he grew up? I don't know if that's what he's on about, but like because of what he's learned over life, he's got that to protect him, like wherever he goes, even now, like he's got that to protect him, like to keep him focused on what he wants to do. We who have Khmer blood are born to be resilient. I'm probably saying the word wrong, but to be resilient. If you wish to challenge us, I doubt that you will be able to endure as we have. Oof, yes, yes. Like, people that grew up from the hardships to where they are now, like, yeah, it's not easy to endure what those people used to have. Like, I'm talking about anybody. I'm not just talking about the Cambodians. I'm talking about, like, South Africans. I'm talking about Africa. Like, everywhere in the world where people had to grow up in some hardships, like, it's not for everybody. And I doubt that people who's grown up in that lifestyle, who hasn't grown up in that lifestyle, can endure what they went through. I agree with that. Hey yo, Vanda is keeping it real all the time. He's keeping it real in this video as well. He says the burden is heavier than you think. This ain't senior year in high school. Like, this ain't senior year in high school. But yeah, the burden is, I'll go with on what he said, the burden is heavier than you think. He's talking about, like, just real life situations, just like, a lot of the stuff that he's spoken about in this song, I can relate to. Like, jeez. Like, he keeps it 100% all the time. This is why I'm saying this dude's on a different level. I've never seen a rapper keep it this real. Well, apart from J. Cole and maybe Kendrick. Like, well, a few rappers have kept it this real. But, like, I don't know. Something different about Vanda.
មិត្តភូមិខ្ញុំយ៉ាងម៉េចហើយពេលនេះអូអូ Hey hey ដល់ដល់សម័យណាហើយពេលនេះចង់ខ្លាចជាទំពាំងនៅស្នងឫស្សី
I wanna be as the shoot that grows strong into bamboo cuz we know bamboo is one of the strongest stuff out there. I think even Jackie Chan said it like in Rush Hour 2. He said Chinese bamboo is very strong. But yeah, in general, I saw this one video like bamboo, like somebody had heated up a metal like to like boiling point or something, and he put it on some bamboo. It didn't even break. So that's what Vand is saying. He's strong like that. Like he, you can try to break him down. You can try to do whatever. You can try to stab him in the back. He ain't gonna budge. He's strong. He's got a strong will. He's got a strong heart. And he ain't budging for nobody. What do you say? I want to see this and see that. Learn this and learn that. Do this and do that. Yep. That's exactly what I'm saying. Like, I'm experimenting with all sorts of things. I want to explore a lot of things as well. I want to do this. I want to do that. I want to learn this. I want to learn that. Yeah. I'm with Vando on the same page. And he's already doing that. He's already living that life. He's already learning this and learning that. And he's still learning this and learning that and doing this and doing that. So yeah, big respects to Vanda. Y'all, see, this is what I'm saying. Y'all always give me like good songs to react to. And yes, there is more Vanda songs coming. Like I've seen a few, like I said, you guys have dropped a few songs for me to listen to by Vanda. So stay tuned for that. I haven't like just scrolled past your comment. I have seen what you guys have been talking about. The Olympics one, though, on the other hand, I might not be able to react to that. There's no subtitles for that one. I tried to see if there was closed captions to that one, but there wasn't. So yeah. But the other songs, yeah, I will be reacting to that soon. So you guys just stay tuned for that. You guys will see more Vanda songs coming soon. Yeah, and my boy just standing there, like looking over like life itself, Mother Nature itself. It's a window to his soul. This is the window to the soul. Like even the camera that's looking at me, that's the window to my soul. Like if that makes sense, like everything is a window. Your eyes is the window to everything. Like he said in the beginning, it's the window to the soul. What I like. That's beautiful. That was a beautiful song by Vanda, Camera Blood. Hope you guys did enjoy this reaction. Man, this guy always keeps it 100% real. Like even, and he always shows love to all these people. That's what I like about Vanda. Vanda always keeps it 100. He always talks about it. He conveys a message to us as at the same time as he's talking about the stuff that he grew up in and the stuff that he adapted to. Like you just gotta keep pushing, keep going forward until you can't no more. He said it in Time to Rise. He said, keep doing what you're doing until you have no more breath. Like yeah. He even said it in this song, like some people will go for fame and drain themselves dry, like don't push yourself too hard at the same time. Like, love what you do and do what you love. That's all I can say, really. Like, he was talking his talk again. And that's why I like Vanda's song so much, y'all. Like, Vanda himself, like, he's a good person. And, yeah, he's different from everybody else. But, yeah, I hope you guys did enjoy this reaction. Hit that like button, and we are out. Bash, mash.